Hello. This is video 1 out of 4, giving some inspiration to how you can make or work with solo drills for a Daneaxe. So, this first video, we're gonna work with the basics. It is your body posture that is the most important here, and we're gonna work with squaring up, which means that you have both your hips perpendicular aligned. Many of us have a tendency to work like this with the Daneaxe, also with two-handed spear. But for this exercise, we'll try to work, and for the rest of the videos, we will work with this stance of being squared up, having your balance more backwards, so you don't have too much weight on the front foot. You can, of course, lean in from here. But this position is what we are working from. So. First drill is simply to square up, and I suggest you have a target to hit. I don't have here, I just show into the air. So point number one, square up, hinge, which means don't stand erect like this, hinge, but don't fall over like this, have a straight back. And so that is the body posture. For the attacks you're gonna make, we're gonna just go for high attacks. You're not allowed to move your hands, no cueing. This is an exercise in just to get the right body posture, fixed hands, and then the attacks you're gonna do is gonna be in a 45 degrees angle, so not this upside down or direct hit like this, but we're gonna have an angle like this. And what I want you to try now, and the way I use my Daneaxe is, I think of it more like a cutting weapon than a chopping weapon. So I make these the English word for it, circle motions, which gives the advantage. I think that both it's better for my body mechanics. These attacks is hard on the elbow, I think, and. And I have to kind of reload before I can make another attack. But with these circle motions, I feel that I am more able to make another attack or block more with a bit of flow, and it works better with the way my body. Moves in a healthy way, I think. So try to square up, meaning not like this, like this. Now I'm hitting that way, and then doing these circle motions. It's okay to lean a little bit into to the cut, but try to see if you can actually just stand like this, yeah, and then change sides. Important with the Daneaxe, I think, to train equally both sides. So the same here, and as I said, have a target to practice hitting on, but the important part is here is more squaring up and the way you cut, not chopping, but cutting, and doing it in these circular motions. Yeah, so try it out.